Let's go forward and build cross sections for this wallet. I will create new part in SolidWorks for finding, for building of the sketches and finding correct dimensions, radiuses. If you see, this cross section has radiuses, and I do not understand from this picture which radiuses we have here, 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 and here. And I must draw it directly in SolidWorks, make sketches, and then rebuild the sketches on my pump part. It's like a process of dimension optimization. Let's create new sketch on front plane, edit picture. Fix this picture and measure this trapezoidal dimensions. Let's find scale ratio 55. I will leave this radius in the document, text document. Sorry, must copy and paste. Oh, sorry, should be 10, 10, yeah, sorry. Let's take this like a ratio, maybe 0.255. Yeah, it would be correct. And multiply this dimension on ratio coefficient. Let's fix this result, save, call cross sections, and create a sketches for these cross sections. Let's make trapezoidal silhouette here, here. Let's add dimensions from here to here, 30, 55, and 20. And fix it in this point. Now I must edit hatch for every cross sections. I will make it approximately the first. hide reference. Make this all once like instruction. We have must open this and let's create edge of every cross section. First is four is here. Next 7.5. 7.5 is here. Next 11 here. Let's check this reference volute. Yeah, correct. Next 14.5, 18, but we have 17.84. 17.84. Not critical. Next 21. Next 24 is here. And last 27. Yeah, it's ready. In another sketch, with using sketch number 2, I can create a cross section and finding radiuses for every cross sections. Create new sketch. So let's make something like this. New sketch. Radius. Remove. And let's find approximately. Yeah, it should be like this. 2.5. Or maybe three. No, 3 is not correct. 2.75. Let's make for every cross sections. Let's check this first. Yes, everything correct. Last section. Let's find radiuses for every section with moving and watching where this radius match with sketch picture. This image. Okay. Let's give dimensions for these radiuses. 4.5 should be without big decimal values. 5.5. Keep this result. If you see everything fine, you can also create this tangent arc and check. I think it's not critical to using this arc. Understand what it's mean, but I think it's not critical without this arc. Using without arc, I will create radiuses after building 3D model of the volute. Let's also build this cross section number 9 with using this reference dimensions. It has 29 millimeters edge. Check, maybe it's a circle. No, it's something another. Use 3 millimeters in these points. save this result. And we have cross section which we will build on this volute. But first I need to create reference planes in every cross section for building this cross section on my 3D model. In my 3D model, yeah. Let's go to build planes. First, second, third, and last sections. For build this cross section, I must create perpendicular. Here, to make it parametric, I must create this perpendicular in every cross section. Make this perpendicular white construction. Now I can build last cross section. I can create reference plane like this. A circle with coincident. The circle is 50 millimeters in diameter. Next, I can create a reference geometry here. I will choose this perpendicular endpoint. And I have a new plane. You can flip normal this plane. For me, it's comfortable to use flip normal like this. You can move it here. We can give a name for this plane. Also build 1, 2 access point and create new plane. Flip, watching for flipping, control flipping of the plane. Yeah. Next. Let's save this result, move again first cross section. Let's make it comfortable. Adjust this plane and rename with using F2 on pad, yeah, second. F2, new name, yeah, ready. F2 is fifth. Six. Seventh. This is 8, should be something like this, IX, let's check, yes, IX, oh, sorry, sorry, not, VI, and 9th cross section. Yeah, if you remember, I was ignore these diameters. It's not really critical because I will build this section from. I think I must build maybe this section 10th, and this I should be built directly, like a circle cross section. Let's start to build cross section sketches from this part. Transfer this sketches on our model. But first, I think I must build something like this in the model. Surface, it's rotated surfaces from both sides. It would be like a reference for me. First cross-section for loading of it. This point together. And we have a triangle for rotation. I think I do not need this triangle from this side. I will use side, and another side is symmetry. Let's create axis for rotation of the surface and make rotational surface. Axis for rotation. Remove this and create this axis. Press enter, and we have reference rotation revolve surface. And now I can start with sketching of cross section areas here. Let's choose operation called intersection curve. Choose this rotation revolve surface, and we have receive intersection curve, but this curve is a straight line. Create horizontal lines for this cross section and choice here pierce point. This pierce point is cross these lines. Pierce point here. Create symmetry line, make it construction, transfer radius 2.75. Can make this white construction also. Let's build another cross section. I will give a name for this cross-section 1, CS cross-section 1, maybe cross-section. Choose another second plane. Choose operation intersection curve. This face and revolve on revolved surface. Call this section cross section 2, second. Make horizontal lines. Vertical symmetry. Yeah. Pierce point with guide curve here. Guide curve, point, pierce. And this guide curve, point. This empower diameter and pierce. This should be construction. Radius 4.5. Third plane, make sketch, choose intersection operation, make it the intersection curve, and same operation like in previous sketches. Radius 5.5. Name for this cross section. New intersection curve, pierce point here, radius. So for this cross section. Plane number 5. Same buildings. Ready, radius 8. Oh, if you see, we have a silhouette, cross sections, like this. From another side, it's another side, should be removed. Name for this cross section. Next. Radius, before we use 8, 10. Six. Move forward, number 7. Point here, this point here. If I do not, if I remember, yeah, let's not forget 11. Let's build another section with same operations. Here's here. Action. Nice for nice cross section. Also should be built from here. We do not use this surface, revolved surface. I can hide this. Build line. But two line here, horizontal, this midpoint, suppose here, here, 29 width. Here and connect this together. It should be tangent here, here, tangent, symmetry in another side. This cross section 14 here and 3 millimeters in radius in this points edges. Yeah. I can also build back in the first sketch. I will call you this like a volute. Choose this tense cross section. With 31, no, it's not a 31, 32. Is not parallel, maybe parallel. No, it's not parallel. Has a small deviation. Graphically, I can show it like angle 4 degree. Make perpendicular for building plane. Discharge, it's I call it discharge, discharge. Let's build last cross section. Number 10 X. It should be a circle, concentric here, coincident, and coincident here, and center is here, and dimension is 32, yeah, in millimeters. I will hide all these reference planes. You see, we have already built sketches for building of volute. And now we must decide how we must connect this more smoothly. I will show you it some later. Right. In next.